Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I am starting this new journey with you guys. I have so much to talk about, but right now I'm just here to say I'm glad that we finally made it throughout this year. This was a long and tired ass year, and there's so much learning and so much awakening that I have to do for myself, but I'm just so glad that we finally made it. We did it, you know? So I know that around this time, everybody's really nostalgic, like, oh, you know, new year, new me, new money, new this, new that. For me, I feel like this year has taught me to just be me, and it taught me how to just do what I needed to do to better for me. And if it means looking in the camera and talking with you guys, then so be it. I feel like this was my time to be awake, my time to be woke, my time to show up, show out, and do what I have to do. Because at the end of the day, we're all here for a purpose. Everybody's just trying to find their own. And here I am, showing you mine. So now that the year is finally over, and we're going into a whole new year with so much expectations, we're unaware of what's gonna happen next, all I can say is, like, listen, fuck worrying about the future, fuck worrying about what's gonna happen, good or bad. Just focus on the now. And that is just generally what I've been doing this past couple of weeks, is just focusing on the now and forgetting everything else. Like, it's been crazy how we go from crunch time of waking up in the morning. We're like fucking robots waking up in the morning, getting our stuff organized, going rushing to get the train, bus, whatever, driving, whatever, just to get to work, to sit there for 8 hours, to do so much work and deal with so much personalities and so much energy. Now that we got the time to just be in our own bubble, I felt like this was the universe just saying, like, listen, it's time for y'all to take a break, slow the fuck down, and reconnect with your family, yourself, and just figure out what you need to do next for yourself. And it's not about, okay, I gotta do this, I gotta do that, I gotta. No, you don't have to think to breathe. So it's just about letting things happen naturally and just going with the flow. And I felt like this year has taught me to just be grateful about everything, be genuine with myself, and just embrace what's to come. Also to follow my intuition. But that's another story for another day. I'm still trying to figure that out, because sometimes my intuition be like telling me a whole nother thing, and then when I do it, it's just like, okay, so what was the purpose of you telling me to do this? So that's another thing for another day. But all I can say is that today is not about how it ends, where it's going, what we're doing, should we do this, should we do that. It's about celebrating life. And that is what I plan on doing when that ball drops, is celebrating life. I'm not celebrating any negativity. I'm celebrating the positive vibrations that I'm getting off of this year. I know that this year has been affected a lot of people. And I just wanted to say this first, that I'm sending out my energy and my condolences to anyone who has lost anyone during this time. It's not easy, and it will never be easy. But the hardest part has already came and gone. The only thing that you can do now is understand that they are not gone. They are still with you and will always be with you. And that if you can feel and remember anything about them, then you don't need to worry about where anything, because they are always going to be with you. And that's, I know that's the hardest thing to ever tell somebody who's really lost somebody that's really close to them, but it's better than not saying, it's better than nothing, to be honest with you. And it's better than not saying that, listen, you're going to be okay. Everyone grieves differently. Everyone can't take that spontaneity of what I just said. Some people be like, what the fuck are you talking about? Like, yo, I just lost somebody that was dear to me. What do you mean it's going to be all right? It's not about thinking the negative side of why this person left. It's about thinking about the positive side of where they are headed or where they're going. It's about knowing that they are in a higher place. I'm not going to say better place, because we are already in a heaven on earth. I'm just saying that they're in a higher being place, in a place where they are in a higher being, in a higher place, a higher plateau, in which they can still be with you. Not mind, body, but still be with you. Physically, emotionally with you. And I just wanted to leave that on that note. But yeah, I'm celebrating life. And I'm at that point where it's just that I can't dwell on the past. I can't dwell on things that's already happened, because it happened. If I sit here and try to think about, okay, my childhood, this happened in my childhood, this happened. And I know I'm rambling on, but I'm just saying that everything I'm feeling about 2020 has to do with what I'm saying right now. It's just about not thinking for fucking once. And I'm the worst when it comes to like thinking. Like, I'm always constantly thinking, even in my sleep. Like, I will wake up and start thinking about shit. And I'd be like, okay, mind, I need you to settle down, because I'm on 4 hours of sleep and I need the other 4 hours. You got me? You get me? So what I'm saying is just like, 2021 is not about changing you per se, but it's about changing your perspective on what you think you know and what you might have seen. 2020 was a vision. I don't care what anybody says. It was a vision. 2020 was a year for everybody to wake the fuck up. 2020 was a year for you to open up your mind and open up your heart and see the compassion surrounding you. That was what it was about. And some people might look at it on a negative note, like, yo, this year was shitty, bro. Lost my job. I ain't got no food on my table. Now, when you had those things, were you grateful? Think about that for a second. When you had those simple things, were you grateful? Now that you don't have those things, you have to see what you need to be grateful for. You understand what I'm saying? And that was just a signification of what happened. Is that we were never grateful for the things that we already had. Simple things that we had. That it had to be taken from us to understand how to be grateful. And with those simple necessities that we needed to survive, tells us that when you get those things back, and you will. I'm not saying that this is the end of the world and anything like that. You will get those things back. But in return of you getting it back, I want you to understand of what you should be grateful for. Now, Thanksgiving is always that time where people be like, oh, I'm grateful for this, I'm grateful for that. No. This is why I don't follow that pagan holiday. I'm just saying that. I'm just speaking my mind. It is what it is. You don't have to have a specific day to do that. It should be every fucking day. So, in reality, when people say, oh, you know, this happened to me, this happened to me. Okay. So how are you going to fix it? Internally, how are you going to fix it? And that's what I got out of this year. I know everybody's probably like, well, I couldn't think like that. I couldn't think like this. I couldn't think like that. That's the problem. You don't think like that. And you should. Once you put your mind into a state where it's just like, yo, I can't depress myself. I can't be in that state where it's just like, you know, nothing's gonna work out. You know, this is happening all the fucking time and I don't know what I'm gonna do. When you start keeping yourself in that type of cycle, you're always gonna have that type of cycle return back to you. What you get put out into the universe is what you get in return. So if you keep putting out that negativity about, oh, this thing shit is always happening to me all the time and nothing ever works out for me, nothing's gonna work out for you. Period. But once you switch the whole perspective and the whole train of thought, that's when you realize that, you know what? Fuck it. This is what we're doing now. This is what we're gonna go about doing now. And whatever works, works. And if it doesn't, we'll figure out another option. And that's just about life. It's just about enjoying everything as it comes, good or bad. Certain times when people say bad things happen to me, it's not about the bad things happening, it's about why it's happening. You know, maybe it's supposed to teach you something. Maybe you're supposed to learn something about what happened. Maybe you're in a lack of something. And it's in the cycle of trying to teach you to transition your train of thought or don't go in that direction. Follow a different path. It's all about having a bit of self-control. And some people don't have that. So even though I'm going into the new year, I have to pat myself on the back. I have to give me one of these. Because I know for a fact, if I didn't change my train of thought and decided to flip the script, flip the light switch on, and go onto the spiritual journey, I probably would have lost my mind. I probably would have sunken into a whole depression this whole year. And instead, I kind of just took myself out of my body and realized, like, this is not what I want for my life. This is not where I want to go. So me opening up a little bit to you guys and letting you know that you can do it too. Don't be afraid on who's watching and why they're watching. Just do it. Because at the end of the day, you could be helping somebody cope through whatever it is that they're probably going through. And that's just what I'm trying to do. It's just let you guys know that, listen, it's gonna be all right. So again, we are at the end and we survived this shit. So I'm celebrating life, and I hope that you guys are celebrating life with me too, because damn it was a rough motherfucking year. You heard when they got Kobe, I was like, yeah, this is not it. This is not it. This is not it. But to all those to all the famous people that have passed, Chadwick Boseman, Kobe Bryant, this year was crazy. But I just wanted to leave that note with you guys. Like, yo, live it up, yo. But live it right. Live it up, but live it right. Be conscious about what you're doing. Be aware of what you're doing. Take a step the fuck back and just say, you know what? This ain't it. I'm not gonna do this. I don't need to do this. It's not part of the aura I'm trying to present. It's not the energy for me. Just say, fuck it. Period. So I just wanted to leave that with you guys and let y'all know, like, listen, celebrate life, because it's only one you got, and only you can be true to you and be good for you. Can't be good for anybody else unless your whole spirit, mind, body, and soul is all right. So with that being said, peace, love.
Somebody set you down, hey.